Hey guys, how you guys doing? It's July 16th, 2019. Hoping you're having a wonderful day, a blessed day indeed. Sitting in traffic, one of the worst things in the world. I mean, it just is. It's awful. And I don't hit it a lot, but when I hit it, man, I hit it, you know? All right, let's talk about a few things that have happened today, some things that have come to light, things that are happening around the world, things that matter to you, all right? To each and every one of you, all right? Let's talk about Iran. All right, let's talk about the missing tanker, okay? After researching via Twitter, different open source intelligence handles on Twitter, we found that what happened was, first off, this tanker was supposed to be from the UAE, all right? The UAE came out and stated, hey, this isn't our tanker. We don't know what the hell you're talking about. You know, we don't have any tanker putting any distress signals out. Everything's all good, okay? This is not going along with U.S. intelligence, okay? So we were all wondering what the heck's going on. We knew this tanker existed. We didn't know exactly where it was. We didn't know anything about the crew. No one's heard anything about it. All the online mapping that people use to track ships and aircraft has not really been panning out lately. They've had a lot of issues over the past couple weeks. That might be part of the whole GPS issue that's happening around the world. I'm not quite sure. But then Iran came out, you know, they like a beam of sun in a cloudy day. Just a terrible stormy day, like a sunbeam coming down on a flower, feeding it, giving it the whole photosynthesis thing, you know. I'm not a botanist, but something like that, you know. Iran comes out, this is what they do. They come out, they say, hey, by the way, boys, just wanted you guys to know, all right, you guys have been talking about that tanker. Well, what happened was they've sent out this distress signal. They had technical difficulties. So what we did, we just had a few of our naval vessels go out there. We put a little tugboat and we tugged it back to Iranian waters. And we are still trying to help them get back on their feet. And that's what Iran came out and stated. That's what Iranian officials came out and stated. They stated, hey guys, these guys were in trouble. We're trying to help them out. All right. Sounds like 100% bullshit, if you ask me. But hey, you know, it could be true. So now we know that currently Iran does have this tanker. This tanker is in Iranian waters. All right. So what a lot of people speculated about this tanker is, you know, true. It was going through the Persian Gulf, through the Strait of Hormuz, and then it turned back and, for some reason, slowed down, and then for some reason, slowly went into Iranian waters, all right? Iran is stating that they are helping them out, nothing further. We have not heard from the crew whatsoever, which is kind of weird. And U.S. intelligence is still putting out that they believe that this tanker may have been taken by Iran, all right? The British are sending another frigate to the Persian Gulf, set to deploy in September, if I am not mistaken. This will add to the coalition, I guess we can't call it that yet, but the coalition against Iran. So that'll be three frigates from the UK inside the Persian Gulf, all right? Another thing that happened was Pompeo came out and stated, hey guys, you know, Iran's ready to negotiate. We think Iran's ready to negotiate with their missile program. You know, our pressure, maximum pressure campaign is working. Well, Iran immediately came out and stated, that's not true. We are not negotiating our missile program. Don't know where you got that from, bud, but just not occurring. That's not happening. So it seems like this is what happens. The Trump administration and its officials come out. They say certain things. They are immediately rebuked. Oh man, it's a hard word to say, am I right? We're sitting here wondering what the hell is going on, you know? Seems to be something par for the course, if you will. Just a norm in today's society when it comes to the Trump organization, the Trump administration, all right? Still, maximum pressure campaign is happening. Still, people are waiting for that dime to drop to see if Iran will take action against a UK tanker. It looks like a lot of allied tankers will be escorted through the Strait of Hormuz. I think it's called Operation Sentinel. They just came out and stated that today. Freedom of navigation, all that jazz. The same thing we did during the tanker war. I think we're going to start doing it again. All right. The U.S. and South Korea are going to be having military drills. And just when you thought, you know, oh man, Trump and Kim, they've got such a great relationship. This is wonderful. Oh my gosh. Well, the North Koreans have come out and stated that they may rethink their whole whole missile test situation if the U.S. and South Korea continue on with these military drills. So we're going to have to watch that situation just because, you know, if the North Koreans are anything, they're unpredictable, all right? So right when you think, oh man, negotiations are going to start again, you know, that's just not going to happen. And, you know, one of my main theories to the whole, why did Trump cross into North Korea? Why did Kim allow him to do that? Why did Kim not only allow him to do that, but invite him to do that, right? Well, you know, North Korea is all about propaganda, okay? So plastering that image of Kim inviting President Trump onto North Korean soil, that's a huge win propaganda-wise for the North Koreans, just like every one of these summits have been. It just gives them international power, gives them international influence, more than they had before, all right? So I'm still a believer that a deal with North Korea when it comes to their nukes and disarmament will not happen, okay? That's just my personal take on it. Okay, you can have a completely different opinion, and I respect that. And I'm not trying to force my opinion on you guys whatsoever. I'm just saying my opinion as of right now is a nuclear deal with North Korea is just not going to work. Right? They've spent years, decades upon decades, trying to perfect this technology. They're not going to give it up that easily. All right. Especially when we still have sanctions on. It's the same thing with Iran. We still have sanctions. They're not going to give in until those sanctions are done. And we're not going to, we're stuck at a crossroads because we're not going to give up the sanctions. You know, it's a double-edged sword there. Trying to think if I can think of anything else that has happened today that we need to discuss while I sit here going like 3 miles per hour. And really, I can't think of anything. You know, we need to watch Iran. That whole situation with the tanker. We're going to have to watch North Korea once these U.S.-South Korean drills occur once again. You know, big things we need to watch, guys. I am still of the mindset that we are not going to see a strike on Iran from the U.S. Or the Western allies. If we do see a strike, we'll see it from Israel or Saudi Arabia. And Israel has been, you know, they've had a few rocket launches towards them, you know, the whole IED balloons, fires starting in southern Israel from Gaza, and they've been very, very restrained in their whole entire course of action. You know, there has been a lot of consequences for these IED balloons, for these random rocket attacks. They've been less frequent, but they have occurred over the past 2 weeks, and Israel hasn't done anything about it. Now, you can point towards the peace deal that they're trying to get through, or the U.S. is trying to get through. You can point towards, you know, maybe a bigger theory here is they know a war with Iran is coming, and so they don't want to start a war with Lebanon or Gaza because they are getting ready for that war with Iran. And we know that they're getting ready for that war with Iran because of the aircraft drill that they had that went all the way to Crete, all right? And if you flip that distance from Israel to Crete, from Israel to Iran, you know, it's the perfect distance, okay? So we know that they are training to bomb Iran if need be. I think they know that a war with Iran's coming. Iran right now is enriching their uranium at 4.5%. and they say that they will go up to 20% if they need to, okay? And that seems to be a red line with Benjamin Netanyahu. So if they get close to that 20%, Israel might decide to bomb Iran. All right, I've gone on too long, kind of rambling at this point. If anything else happens this evening, I'll let you guys know. We'll talk about it, we'll discuss it. All right, grab a beer, say a few prayers, and as always, keep your eyes to the skies. God bless.